Monday, we aired a story about a domestic cat attack in Rexburg that sent two people to the hospital. The story was seen all around the country, and it has a lot of you talking. Eyewitness News reporter Stephen Pope digs deeper into this to find out why a house cat viciously turned on its owners.
When Jackie Ostermiller grabbed her cat while it was reacting to a perceived threat, it jumped at her. Dr. Paul Tu says in an agitated state, cats attack everything non-specifically.
Often when a dog or a cat attacks, I see, especially in cats, there's a release of the epinephrine or adrenaline hormone, and the nervous system reacts in a fight or flight mode.
In the Ostermiller's instance, there wasn't an opportunity for their cat to flee, so it attacked.
Suddenly they will turn rage, and the claws and the fangs come out, and the eyes dilate, and they go into a fearful rage. And that's because cats have an easily provoked rage center.
The damage done to Jackie Ostermiller has many baffled. How could a cat do this much damage? But Dr. Tu says it's possible for cats to inflict massive damage. Giant fangs give deep puncture wounds, and all four claws work together in a raking motion. The Ostermillers contend that when their cat attacked, it was going for the kill, but that may not be the case.
When they're out hunting, they are ambushing a prey, and then they have to go in for the kill, and they're going to claw and bite and try to break the neck of the prey, usually is what they're going after. Now, when they're attacking a person or a larger animal, they're not going to be able to kill it, but if they can cause enough pain and inflict enough damage, then they may scare the predator or the person away.
Dr. Tu says the best advice is to never touch a cat in an agitated state and isolate cats that have recently given birth. Or even better, spay and neuter your pet. Stephen Pope, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
The Rexburg Police Department says they have received numerous emails and phone calls from all around the country about the possible euthanization of the cat. So for your information, the cat's future is still in question. Right now, it's finishing 10 days in quarantine.